I would next recognize Anastasia McNeil.
Hi.
Good afternoon.
My name is Anastasia McNeil. I'm from Gary. My mother and I wrote this because my grandmother died of lung cancer. My mom cannot be here today to read, so I'm going to read this in her place. As I read this, I want you to think about all the doctors who are trying to help their patients and all the patients who are suffering and the family members who have to watch their loved ones suffer. Would you have pain here or there? I would not like pain here or there. I would not like pain anywhere. Would you like pain in your house? Would you like to watch your dying spouse? I do not like pain in the house. I do not like to watch my dying spouse. I do not like pain here or there. I'd like to stop it everywhere. I do not like suffering and pain. I do not like them, but they remain. Would you solve them with a plan? Why sit there and say you can't? Do you want to say, not with a note from a man in white coat? Not if you're sick, I don't care one lick. You may not use it here or there. You may not use it anywhere. You may not use a plan for pain. I prefer more suffering. Would you, could you take that pain? Then suffer, suffer. You'll remain. But I would not, could not give you pain that a plant could solve growing with dirt and rain. You may like choice. You will see. You may like choice, just like me. I do not like pain in a house. I do not like to watch a dying spouse. When a little plant growing with dirt and rain could take away that suffering.
Thank you very much. Other questions? That was excellent. Okay. We're going to shift gears a little bit here and recognize Richard Freight, the Chief of Enfield, and the representative of the Hampshire Chiefs of Police.
Thank you. Good afternoon. I'm going to be brief. I've been represented already on some of my comments. Some of the other people. I am Richard Craig Jr. with the Enfield Police Department, but I'm here on behalf of the New Hampshire Chiefs of Police Association. And we are strongly opposed to this legislation. While we understand the compassion argument, and my heart goes out to those people suffering, we must balance between what may help a small portion of our society and the harm it would cause to the larger group. That group I'm concerned about is our children.